The reason for Apollo that Kennedy envisioned initially was to beat the Soviet Union to the moon. The administration didn't particularly care about space travel or about the moon itself, but it represented an audacious goal that would clearly put America first in terms of space and technology. The downside of doing that is the old saying, "You live by the sword, you die by the sword." When the US got to the moon, it was basically game over. We beat the Russians, so we put some flags down and did some science experiments. But pretty quickly after Apollo 11, within a few more missions, Richard Nixon canceled the program because the political objectives had been met. So fast forward 50 years, this is a very different environment. We're not doing this to beat the Russians or the Chinese or anybody else, but to begin a sustainable exploration beyond Earth's orbit. The Artemis program is driven by a number of different goals. It includes in situ resource utilization, which means using resources at hand like water, ice, and lunar soil to produce food, fuel, and building materials. The program is also helping to establish a lunar and space economy, starting with entrepreneurs, because SpaceX is very much part of this first mission to the surface of the moon. NASA doesn't own the Starship, but is buying seats to allow astronauts to go to the surface. SpaceX will then use the Starship for other purposes, to transport other payloads, private astronauts, and astronauts from other countries. 50 years of technology development means that going to the moon now is much less expensive and more technologically feasible. And much more sophisticated experiments are possible when you just figure the computer technology. Those 50 years of technological advancement have been a complete game changer. Almost anybody with the financial resources can send spacecraft to the moon now, though not necessarily with humans. NASA's Commercial Lunar Payload Services contracts private companies to build uncrewed landers to go to the moon. Professor Jack Burns, the author of this story, and his colleagues have a radio telescope that's going to the moon on one of the landers in January. That just wouldn't have been possible even 10 years ago. The current U.S. administration has said that in that first crewed flight on Artemis 3, there will be at least one woman and very likely a person of color. They may be one and the same. There may be several. Professor Burns says he's looking forward to seeing more of that diversity, because young kids today who are looking up at NASA can say, "Hey, there's an astronaut who looks like me. I can do this. I can be part of the space program." Don't forget to watch the video on the right and subscribe. Thanks for being part of Cosmoknowledge.